Wow, look at this. This is a lovely byway. I've never been along here. Well, it's always good to look at the map when you're planning an adventure. And I've come up with this. I just found this local feature called the Hangman stone. So from my home, measure the distance as the crow flies. I live on the outskirts of Swindon, so it's 16.7 kilometres or 10.3 mile in a beeline, but obviously I'll be taking a slightly different route to that. Probably going to go on the byways and the bridleways, I think, and yeah, I think I'll go and take a look at the Hangman stone. Oh dear. When I was here last time it was flooded as well, but obviously the recent rain, yeah, I've only got 100 yards to go that way, but I'm not going to get through. I have to go a different route. So we're now in meteorological winter, and as you can see I've got the old down jacket on, just keeping my pace low so I don't break into a sweat, with the exercise the bicycle forwards, so obviously it's keeping me a lot warmer than if I was perched up on my motorcycle. Anyway, I want to cycle out to see the Hangman stone. So we've got a bit of a climb to do before we get there, and we're going to go up through Liddington and see the combs at Liddington as well. It's a very enigmatic thing, is the Hangman stone, and there's a story attached to it. And I'll tell you the story of the Hangman stone when we get there. Whilst I remember, shout out to PlanetX, because I'm riding the PlanetX Bootzipper. I had to send the first one back because the frame was too small for me. PlanetX were brilliant, changed the frame over, and I got the bike back within 5 days at no cost. So I really am very impressed with the service and the quality of the Bootzipper. I'll show you the bike as well a little later on into the ride. Well, bit of a climb as you can tell, possibly looking behind, but the low gear on the Bootzipper really makes it quite straightforward and not too much of a push at the top of this hill here. This is where you can look across and see the combs, which are sort of workings where they used to terrace the land to make a more growing area, I think. Anyway, the combs at Liddington are really quite spectacular. I have brought the drone with me, but unfortunately the weather's just a bit too inclement to fly it, so you'll have to make do with what shots we see using the GoPro. So this is the combs just here. Really spectacular. Sadly, not a particularly great day for photography. Unfortunately no drone flying, too windy and too wet. I'm just coming up to the pub. It's now called the Burge, but to my way of thinking and to many old timers, it'll always be the Shepherd's Rest. And that's it there. And from here we've got to pick up the ridgeway and 6 miles along the ridgeway. So anyway, yeah, the shepherd's rest. Well, that's a stiff old climb, but the low gearing really helps, I can tell you. Well, I'm at the Ashbury Folly and the crossroads at Border Ridgeway, just above Ashbury. And for those of you that watched my King Alfred's Way journey, this is where I started the King Alfred's Way from. And there's I'll put a link up to that adventure in the top right hand corner of the screen. Anyway, along here now for another couple of miles, then we turn right off the beaten track. Well, I just turned off the ridgeway, which is behind me, and heading down a track to a place called Compton Bottom. And then we're really quite remote, and this track I'm cycling along now, it basically runs parallel with the B4000, which is the road which goes from Ashbury village to Lambourne. And it's not far from Lambourne, on the outside outskirts of Lambourne, where we pick up another byway which takes us up to the Hangman Stone. So yeah, we're up on the Downs. Interesting thing about the name Downs, I learnt from a comment someone left, that it comes from the word dun. Dun, which is an old word which means hills. So we're up on the Downs, up on the hills. Totally isolated and very quiet, and quite beautiful in a bleak, wintry sort of way. Well, I said I'd show you the bike again, so thanks to One, they, or PlanetX rather, One Bikes, they took the old bike back, and which had a medium sized frame, and they fitted the large frame for me. One thing I'll say about the sizing, I was at the crossover size, so I'm 5'10", and you can either fit a medium or a large on that size, but I found with the medium I had the seat post right the way up, and it just felt wrong for me. And PlanetX, brilliant service from them, so shout out to them if they're watching. Thanks for what you've done to help me there. I got the large frame. I'm absolutely loving this bike, it's fantastic, it rides so well. It's not built for speed, but you know, I don't want to go fast anymore, I'm quite happy to go slow. I think my average speed for this journey is around about 9.5 to 10 miles an hour. So that's plenty quick enough for me. I've put holders on the forks. I've got a bag at home for this one, which I haven't used yet. But on this side I've got the bag which is fitting. I use it rather for spare parts and tools, puncture repair, pump, etc. in there. I fitted these bars, or rather on one, PlanetX fitted them for me. You can choose the extras you want on the bikes. And I thought these would be nice because they give me the ability to put my tent over the top and have a bits and pieces you can strap them on. Just a good way to carry stuff really. Another thing, I bought a new tent. In fact, I bought two new tents. The first one I bought was the Snowpack Ionosphere. I thought that'd be a great stealthy option for bike packing. And then when I put it up in the garden, I thought, nah, it's just going to be too drafty and too claustrophobic for long winter nights. So I'll keep that in reserve for the summertime. And then I bought another one, which was after watching Border Rambler on YouTube. It's the Helm Compact One by Terra Nova, and I think that'll fit the bill for perfectly for winter bike packing trips and overnighters, because it's got virtually a solid inner, so it'll keep the winter drafts away. You know, nice to be in a nice warm tent rather than a drafty mesh tent, which some of these three season tents are. So that'll be coming out on a quick test probably in the very next video next week. But back to the bike again. So it's a 1x12. I'm not sure the gearing on it, it's incredibly low, and I can get up any hill, virtually any hill, with comparative ease. I fitted three bottle racks to what I'm using at the moment, and a couple of spare bottle racks down there. Flat pedals, because I like to wear walking shoes with a good grip. A bit of mud stuck on there. Hydraulic disc brakes packed there on the back, just full of just a few snacks in there to keep me going. That's the bike. I really love it. It's fantastic. It really is fantastic. Also, having the low frame means I can put my leg over without having to lift my leg too high. I have got a slight issue with my right hip, but thankfully with moderate exercise it seems to be doing it the world of good. So I think I can continue on. Anyway, let's get pedaling. Not too far to go now. Look at that for a view. That is lovely. That is absolutely gorgeous. There's something so special about coming out, even on a cold winter's day like this, to be able to see the beauty that is all around. Fantastic. Wheels on this bike are 29-inch wheels, and I did come along here a few weeks ago on my other mountain bike, which has got 26-inch wheels, and I'll tell you, there's definitely a difference with the larger wheels. They roll, they do seem to roll over the terrain just a little bit easier, I feel, because I'm able to ride long here off, basically off-piste. Holding one hand on the camera, one hand on the handlebars, and the bike just rolling beautifully. Oh, I made it across the high and remote downs to Upper Lambourne. We go along here for a little way, and then we pick up another bridle way, which takes us on up to where the Hangman Stone is. So yeah, very pretty. This is horsey country here. Lots of stables, lots of horse riders. Luckily I haven't met any, and normally out training the horses, but there's big gallops behind me. Ah, nice old building, look. A bit of age and history to that. I think it's just here that I turn left, and we head back up onto the more remote downs again. Yeah, this is it. So along here we've got a bit of a climb, and then we're more or less at the Hangman Stone. I say quite an old lane this, because it's sunken. You can see the banks rising up on both sides. That's an indication of a very old path or a very old trackway. Okay, top of this this hill, the road forks round to the left. Well, I'll go left and right, but I got to go left here, and then it goes left again, and that's where the Hangman Stone is. Although it's not that left there, it's the next one down. Lovely, peaceful bridleway. Actually, I think it's a byway. You can ride motorcycles along here at certain times of the year. Yeah, coming up on the left now, I can see it. Yeah, it's this left I want. Oh, bit of rubbish. That's a shame, isn't it? Such a shame. Along here, shall we? That, I believe, is it. That's the Hangman Stone. Right. So, this is the enigmatic Hangman Stone. Well, what can I tell you about it? Not a lot, really. It could have been used as a gibbet point in the past, but the story that's attached to it and to other Hangman Stones in the British Isles is that a livestock thief. This particular person had stole a sheep, and he made his way up to this stone where he decided to stop and rest, and then whilst he was resting, the sheep managed to tangle him up in the rope and then struggled to get away, and during the ensuing struggle the thief was choked to death. So that's the story which is associated with the Hangman Stone. And I believe it's also the story that's associated with other Hangman Stones in the British Isles. Probably not a grain of truth in it at all. It's probably a boundary marker, I expect. Or it could well have been a place where they used to have a gibbet, maybe in the dark, distant past. For me too, it's also going to be a place where I'm going to stop and rest. Got some water, an orange, and some fig rolls. So life is good. It can only get better. So anyway, I'll leave the video here. The next video is going to be camping. I got this new tent to try. I'll probably have a little adventure on the Bootzipper again, and have an overnighter. Not sure where I'm going to go, but it's bound to be fun. Just one more thing I almost forgot to mention. I'm recording this on the Strava. So if you check out the description box of this video, you'll find a link to my Strava and to this particular ride. And if anyone is local or wants to try this ride out, you can download that, the map, and put it on your GPS device, whatever it is you're using, or a phone. And then you can follow the exact path that I've cycled to get to see the Hangman Stone. So anyway, from me and the Hangman Stone, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.